75% of businesses were accessing public funding for training. 8 out of 10 businesses who had provided training did so using an external training provider, and we asked some questions about the satisfaction of providers. The highest satisfaction levels were recorded for independent training provision, followed by HE, and the lowest being FE sector. We also asked a number of questions about apprentices, and overall 23% of businesses in the survey were employing an apprentice, and 56% were aware of the levy, which is actually higher than we thought it would be. So in terms of the next steps, what we'll be doing over the next month is we've got a series of focus groups in the diary, which each of the chambers of commerce across the city region will be hosting. We've also got some focus groups working with some of the LET sector panels. The chambers in particular will be focusing around SME skill needs, but also looking at particular sectors around advanced material manufacturing and where there's high potential for growth. The more detailed analysis and qualitative feedback will be looked at. We'll get that back into a much richer analysis, and then we'll use that to inform a skills investment statement which we need to produce in the next month or so, which will help inform the commissioning of funding within the FE sector in this next year, and then this will feed into our longer term skills strategy.
Thanks for your questions. Thanks, Steve. Just a few points really. I don't think anyone would be surprised at the challenges that businesses are facing at the moment in terms of recruiting the right people. The survey is obviously a very comprehensive one. Congratulations to the people who've undertaken that. A couple of things I'd say in terms of linking this to the wider economic development agenda there, which I think is important for the LEP in particular to note. Of those companies that were surveyed, and there was a big number that were surveyed here, you say only 10% were operating outside of the locality in terms of its customer base. I think that's a concern. I think that given the fact that we've got the International Business Festival next year coming, highlighting the opportunity around exporting, I think is important. But actually in Merseyside, exporting can be working with companies in Manchester. That's how bad we are in terms of looking outward for our customer base in terms of our business community here. And I think there's a huge amount of work to be done to actually improve the ambition of some of the businesses that are currently operating in Liverpool. And my fear actually is that not only are we suffering from a skills gap, we're suffering from a lack of ambition. An ambition gap that it is starting to see some companies, particularly in the digital sector, which obviously you will be well aware of now with your new portfolio responsibility, looking outside of Merseyside and to relocate to other parts of the north and elsewhere. So I'd like to see the evidence that's been collated here not simply siloed into the skills agenda, but actually broadened so that the local enterprise fellowship in particular starts to look at what they can do through their business support mechanisms to work with some of these companies to actually encourage them to be less parochial, more ambitious, and certainly to start to identify businesses that perhaps have an opportunity, perhaps no better chance to highlight that through the IDF next year. The other thing that often frustrates me, not just in this city but elsewhere, is that Chambers of Commerce are great, but they're one of only several business organisations that operate in the Liverpool city region. I won't mention the obvious one, which is the biggest membership organisation in Liverpool. You wouldn't know really, would you? I know Mark's here, and I've spoken to Mark, and I see about this in the past. I would simply say, can we ask the chambers to involve and work alongside those other business organisations so that we get the wide reach of business involved. Chambers of Commerce, great, but they would say themselves they represent a small number of businesses across the city region. We've got the Forum of Small, the Federation of Small Business, we've got the Institute of Directors, you've got the Women's Organisation, you've got a whole range of other business membership groups now that we really do need to start to engage with on this very important agenda. And for me, there is no excuse anymore for us not to do that, because everybody is well aware that those organisations exist, and each and every one of them have a reach into constituencies and businesses who need to be involved in this agenda.
I won't be silly, and I think Mark as well. It's also part of the connection Councillor Davis's and my portfolio. And to tell you the truth, it's cross-cutting across every portfolio. So you're right, we need to ensure that this is embedded cross-departmental, like cross-portfolio within the combined authority. You did mention the IBF or IFB or whatever it's called, 2018. That falls under a Sir Hammond's portfolio. What we'll do is we'll ask for a presentation at the next combined authority, because that obviously is funded through combined authority. It's one of our devolved agenda issues that we need to pick up anyway. So it's just preempted something that we'll need to do that sooner rather than later. Sue first.
Just to pick up on the points, and particularly around the primary markets outside of the UK, that question was specifically included at the request of the LEP. So just to reassure you, we're working hand in hand with the LEP on this survey, and the findings will be far-reaching. We do need to cut across a whole range of sectors. I think we suspected that was going to be the answer when we actually put the question in, but it does raise a number of issues, and it links to some of the issues that are coming through around the low pay as well. I think that there is a predictive of the way some of the employers are operating.
Mark, you specifically mentioned the internationalisation agenda, and also stuff that Frank Wright is talking about. We're not really reaching far beyond the borders of the city region. We know about the functional economic. What we do is an export commission.
Thanks, Chair, and thanks to Frank for raising those points. I completely agree with this analysis of the city region's economy. We've been making a point for some time. It's in the growth strategy that was produced last year. There's a need for greater ambition, need for greater exporting, and that's absolutely exporting outside of the region, because that's where you start. We need to develop our businesses with the right products and services that are competitive. By trading regionally, nationally and internationally, you become much more competitive, exposed to competitive pressures. We see great productivity in our big companies, Jaguar, Land Rover, Unilever, that lead the world in productivity and productivity gains. We don't have the same cascading of productivity and competitiveness in the tiers below that. So they're all absolute strategic priorities that we've got to drive forward for the city region. And as you said, Chair, we're looking to an export commission in the course of the next couple of months to work with those successful exporters, the ambitious ones, to encourage and entice others into that space. And we'll be doing hopefully some internationalisation strategy work to determine the best places to encourage our businesses to export successfully over the course of the couple of years of the strategic approach. So hugely important that we take that ambition forward.
Thanks very much.
Sorry, Steve, could I just have some reassurance about other business organisations as well?
Yeah, just to come in on that, the wider work we're carrying out on our employee skills survey itself, we're going through a process of engaging with employers, business networks, part of that. I'll get in touch with the outside of this to make sure we cover up that wider grouping.
Frank and I'll ensure that all businesses, wherever possible, are included in that. In his absence, can we thank Councillor Mayor for his input into the last two agenda items? And can we agree the recommendations which pertain to the presentation? Item 10 is it's a report which seeks approval for two feasibility fund requests, which are future proofing of the JF Junction 23, the M6 motorway, and the development of the city views and internationalisation strategy, which is spoken about. Both of these are key to the city's future development, and Dale will take us briefly through this report.